When I was younger, I was at some point born. I grew in both IQ and EQ, and as that happened, I discovered that I was living in two realities at once. They fought all the time, and yet I made space for both of them for a reason I can't explain. One reality I experienced was my earth reality, the day-to-day painting of what I was taught was my natural state in life. At the time, I also experienced a dream simultaneously, and this dream was in combat with my earth reality at all times. A vision where I performed my thoughts for the world, a world where I mattered in a different way, a world where I was valued for different things. And in this world, I was kind, and that kindness spread through people, through sound. This was the birth of Chromatica.
I know there are times when physically we reflect what's going on mentally and emotionally, and it becomes a physical reaction. It's called a panic attack. But it all starts with this idea, unless of course you're under physical threat. For the most part, when we suffer from mental health issues, which I do as well, it starts from something internal. And is that ultimately what you're looking to be pulled out of?
When I get stuck in that, like, that trauma response feedback in my brain, I have no concept of my body at all. I'm completely in my head. And then I say, I'm tired of screaming at the top of my lungs, things I used to do upstairs before I'd come down into the studio with blood pop. I'm in the hole. I'm falling down, so down, down. My name isn't Alice, but I'll keep looking for Wonderland. So it's kind of this... It's this weird experience where I'm going, I'm not sure I'm gonna make it, but I'm gonna try. This is a mental issue. I radically accept that I have it. And although I feel completely disconnected and offline, I am still going to pursue Wonderland. Thank you. I'm still going to look for something that I do not have right now. And maybe it is through just simply trying. I think that being brave is hard, but it's synonymous in many ways with trying.
One of the things that's most evident to us when we find clarity is the decisions we made in our lives and the way that we self-sabotage in order to punish ourselves.
Yeah.
And we make dumb decisions because we don't know any better and we think we're dumb and that's what we deserve.
You know, I've been open about the fact that I, you know, used to cut. And I've been open about the fact that I've have had masochistic tendencies that are not healthy, and they're ways of expressing shame, they're ways of expressing feeling not good enough, but actually they're not effective. They just make you feel worse. And you think that you deserve to be hurt, and you think that you don't deserve good things. You think you don't deserve happiness. These are some of the things that I've been through. And then I stopped and I forgave myself eventually. But I think I forgave myself because I decided that I was human and that made me feel better.
And now you're able to feel love and be loved, right? And know yes. what it feels like and not try to burn it down because you don't no. deserve it.
As I love someone more, I am internally being yelled at by a voice that is buried inside of me. And it's hard, but it's worth fighting for. You know, one of my favorite lyrics on this album is, every single day, yeah, I dig a grave. Then I sit inside it wondering if I'll behave. It's a game I play, and I hate to say, you're the worst thing and the best thing that's happened to me. All this stuff that made me start the album with, could you pull me out of this alive, right?
Yeah.
All that stuff, that's exactly the stuff that pointed to my humanity. It's exactly the stuff that pointed to my ability to make music. It's exactly the stuff that brought me back to who I am. So I guess what I'm trying to say, Zane, is if you're listening to this album and you're suffering in any type of way, just know that that suffering within itself is a sign of your humanity, and you are not broken. You are connected to the whole world, and we are one giant body. We are one full entity, and the whole you is having a whole human experience. And there might be parts of your life that feel like completely shallow or robotic or ancillary and unimportant, and that's okay, but that suffering is a sign that you're real, and it's a way to ground yourself. Like, I've actually learned that when I feel that way, I can go, well, I'm a person and this is very real and I'm human. And even though for many years, because I've changed my hair color or my looks or my wigs or my outfits, I have somehow allowed myself to have a life where I've given the narrative away and it's been written for me, I can actually take it back by saying, no, I'm a human.
Don't call me Gaga. I've never seen one like that before. Don't look at me like that. You amaze me.
My heart,
my little monsters!
My heart,
you amaze me. Put your paws up.